Hello, my name is Oriol. I come from Technical University of Madrid and works on CATE department. It's a department about e-learning in the university. And in this presentation, we focus in an example of MOOC course based on an important learning community. We begin to explain what is a MOOC, but I think all of you know what is this. But what are MOOC? MOOC is a massive online open course. It's a course where anyone can join into any course without dependence of the level of the course. We can identify two types of MOOCs, X and C MOOCs. The first one are like a traditional online course with contents provided for teachers and assignment with self-assignment quizzes test. The principal differences are that the contents are video lectures on spite of text of the typical online course. And these lectures, video lectures, it's uploaded to YouTube channels and appears one type of assessment based on peer-to-peer evaluation. The students evaluate to another peers. CMOOC are more connective. In this case, in this type of MOOC, the teacher take a role of facilitator where try to guide to students to create connections between the information and between the other peers. The faculties that we find in MOOCs is the first one is the massiveness. There are a lot of students and we need that students help another peers because the faculty can help all students. Normally, you can think about that the MOOCs have more than 5,000 or more students. We found another problem with the MOOC platform that it's we need it's a platform that's closer because we need to log in and leave personal information like name or email and does not have too much social tools for interactions between students and with the faculty and doesn't offer space to share the contents. Virtual learning communities it's defined as a group of people who have a common thematic affinity and are connected via different communication tools on web. In this case, it's not in a real place, a difference with a traditional classroom. And we can use social networks to create these communities. And the difficulties that we find with virtual learning communities, all people that work in these communities have any literacy. Because, for example, anyone can know how to create an account on Facebook or how to publish any content, but not advanced digital literacy. They have problems, for example, with the privacy or not how to search contents or doesn't know what they can publish, how kind of licenses have the content that they publish. And another concept is digital citizenship. In this case, members must know the community how it works, the community policy, and avoid duplicate information or publish spam or any kind of content that is not addressed about a topic community. And the solution for CMOOC that we propose is virtual, it's combined learning management system like a MOOC platform with a social network like a virtual community to improve interaction and connections between students, instructors, and contents. We show a piece of a study applications of social network to education, virtual communities. This MOOC we offered last year in November in Yaraki's platform. This course during 5 weeks and win the first award that Miyadaikis received this year. This course not only pretend to train on running social networks and apply this for a classroom, this course would like to take advantages of the collective intelligence of all students. The course and the organization was divided in 5 modules with 4 hours of work per week. We have a 1 module 0 as a learning guide, and the module 1, the next one, it's a introduction with we talk about web 2.0 and virtual communities. The 3 follow-up modules talk about different social networks, and we center on Twitter and Facebook and their applications on education. And the last 1 module talk about another types of social networks that we can use to education. All modules have one self-assessment quiz, and we propose 2 peer-to-peer activities where the students evaluate another peers. The resources that we use are short videos with the mean duration of about 5 minutes, uploaded to institutional channel UVM or YouTube, and each video talks about one topic of the module. This video was embedded in a web page and accompanied, in most cases, of a complementary text to strengthen the video information. For all issues of students, we encourage them to publish into a virtual learning community of the course for the other students or the faculty can to do response. The course was established in the MOOC Miyadaikis platform, where the video resources was linked to YouTube, and we uploaded all PDF and all text to the Google Drive and linked from the Miyadaikis platform. And we propose 2 video conferences along the course with the students, where they can expose the educational projects, and we use for this a free tool Google Hangouts. For social community or learning community, we use for one side the Miyadaikis forum with no more success because they don't work fine, and on the other hand, we opted to use 2 social networks external to the platform and to develop the learning community. This is 2 social networks. We opted for make a previous study among the major networks we searched this criteria. A sense of community, the number of users that we can form part of the community. It's very important the content organization and search, if we can search any content, or we can use hashtags or mentions or categories. No hierarchies, because we like that all members' publications have the same relevance in the community, and it's easy to manage the community. We try Google Plus and Twitter, and you can see the data of the course. The more important is that the 20% is finished the course, a higher than average percentage of completion of MOOCs. I think that 819 students that finish one course is a very good result, because it's a real number, and 20% of the course. because people in most of cases don't have time to work to finish the course or don't like or don't necessarily need a certificate or only interest in a one module of the course. I mean, for this, the people don't finish in most of cases. And we use the resources of the social networks in the case of the Twitter. When we begin the course, we think that it's a good option, this social network for the course. But when finished we discover that that for a great number of students, it's difficult to manage this social network, and this not have a community sense because the users find in the timeline a lot of tweets, not only tweets of the course, they find tweets of the other people that they follow, and it's problem to manage and follow the course. Another problem that is the members don't use or don't use correctly hashtags and mentions in Facebook, and it's difficult to follow the discussions, for example, and there's the limit of extension of the tweets. In the case of the Google Plus, the results was better and very enriching. It's very simple to manage and have a good sense of community. We can organize easily all content with hashtags and categories associated to each publication, and it's very easy to find any kind of content in the community, and not have problems with the extension limit. This community to this day remains open, and anyone can publish any content and connect with another professionals. The course is finished in December, and today the people it's talking and to the community during the course. More than 100 publications we have in the course, but we finished more than 100 publications this account in April. The problem that we have in Google Communities tool is that I don't have any tool to count the publications, and it's a problem. I need to count one follow per one or by one. And if anyone knows a tool, please send me an email. And the conclusions, the community, the course has succeeded creating a learning community that lives beyond its own life. The course participants are still running and interacting in the community, and they publish their personal tasks of the course, all the activities, and a great number of students publish these activities for all in open. And we will find new ways to motivate the students to participate in the learning community, not only during the course, and try to connect another professionals outside the course and in the community. And in the future editions of the course, we will use Google Plus and leave Twitter for students practice only in the specific module. Thank you for your attention, and this is my contact, and do you have any questions?